I wish I had the gumption to take on such things. I'm scared of death in a second, but I'm going to get through this. Math can be awesome. Math can be, I know people don't like to hear me say that. I used to be a computer scientist and I wanted to get a journalism major, so I love the sciences, so people are like, you're crazy, but no, math is your friend, because math can explain the universe. And now I'm done talking about math. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Community Poetry right here in Half Price. Hi, you guys are double plus awesome. I'm your guest host today because Tom is doing more and more poetry stuff, because it is National Poetry Month, yippee-skippy, and so I get the honor of taking over this thing. So I thought, because he usually reads a few things, I would read a few things before I would bring out our feature. Oh, give it up for Miss Jackson herself. Yeah, come on, girl. Oh, sorry. I should not be so goofy. All right. I talk about that because she's going to read something from cc&d at the beginning, but cc&d magazine, full name Children, Churches, and Daddies magazine. We just had this discussion, but it's a magazine that often talks about those dysfunctional things within those issues. So anywho, new issue of cc&d came out. It was called equal, and it's a proof copy of it. It just came out yesterday, and I thought I would just grab a couple things up here. Here's a haiku in the middle of this thing called Of His Thirst. Of my dead Scotsman, they spoke of his drinking, but never of his thirst. Mm-hmm. What I am going to do is share some performance art poems for you that are in here, because there's a performance art section, and there are three, and I've got three poems for you. This first one is called Being God. It's about relationships. It's not about I'd like to fill you in case you were worried. I was giving you a Children, Churches, and Daddies poem. This is called Being God. I'm tired of dying for your sins over and over again. And why is it that I'm the one that's doing all the dying and you're the one that's doing all the sinning? I don't think you're learning your lesson. I'm tired of taking this knife to my hands over and over again, giving myself the stigmata, and the blood gets all over my clothes, and I can never get the stains out. And for what? For you to see how I suffer? I'm tired of being humble when I'm supposed to be the one with all the power. Over and over again, I become your servant, and never are you bowing to me. I don't even get a thank you. I'm tired of preaching to the converted when the converted aren't even really listening. They're just snoring in the back rows while I deliver my sermon over and over again and delivering it, and it's not even air conditioning here, and I'm sweating. I'm tired of coming to you and healing the sick, taking away the problems over and over again, giving you something to look forward to, and all I have is an eternity waiting for someone to take my place and tend to my wounds. I'm tired of giving the earth up to you, watching the devil's work be done. And you know, he's just sitting down there and he's looking up at me and he's laughing over and over again, because it's so easy for him when he doesn't have to work. I'm tired of being your salvation over and over again when you turn to me and all I have is no one to turn to but myself. It's a real pain in the ass, you know, being your own God, since no one can save me from me. I'm tired of being your teacher, handing you what you need on a silver platter and waiting for that collection plate, and someone is always stealing out of it from the back rows. I know who you are, you who leave me nothing. I'm tired of wearing this crown of thorns over and over again, and the needles prick my skin. Even gods bleed, at least this one does. And when I ask you to wipe the blood out of my eyes, well, I can't see you anywhere. I'm tired of being something for everybody when everybody is nothing for me. Maybe the devil has the right idea, you know? Maybe I'll just sit back and wait for you to miss me as you wonder, who's your messiah now? Being God. Applause is unnecessary. Save it for her. Save it for our features. This one is a Dripping Springs edit. Because Dripping Springs is around here, true happiness in the new millennium. Sometimes it seems the more I ask for, the less I receive. The only true freedom is freedom from the heart's desires. And the only true happiness This way lies. I'm here to rush you on a whole new millennium, and I'm here to say that we're starting anew. So fasten your seatbelts, hang on to your hats, place your seat trays in an upright and locked position, for it's a bumpy ride, and I'll tell you why. Well, you need a leader, and I'm stepping up to the plate. You keep asking for a big brother, and I'm here to set you straight. You want someone to wipe your noses for you? Well, pick up the tissue and do it yourself. Because when you give up your rights, you take away mine, and we're not having any of that. I'm here to usher in a whole new millennium. I'm here to usher in a whole new generation. You say that, and they say that Eve...
Olivia, your offer's ready.
They say that Eve ate from the tree of knowledge, but you know, she shouldn't have stopped just there. Because the loggers are raping the trees of knowledge. The loggers are raping the force of talent, the force of ability, the force of reason, of skill, of logic, perseverance, and life. We're letting them rape the force of excellence. And you know, it's now time to take it all back, because I'm here to usher in a whole new millennium, and I'm here to tell you how it's going to be done. You keep looking for peace in all the wrong places. You keep asking your leaders to save you from yourselves. But your leaders are losers, and they're worse off than you. It's time to make choices, and it's time to lay claim to everything that we've been blindly giving away. Because I'm here to usher in a whole new millennium. Take charge of yourself, and I'll take charge of me. I'm my leader, not yours. So wipe your own noses. Take it in your own hands, people. Mold your own tools. This is the new millennium, and this is your chance. Because no one should be showing us how to fail. People mastered that feat a millennia ago. So set your own rules and do something fast, because it's time to take charge and it's time to be alive. I'm here to tell you that there's a new sensation, and I'm here to tell you that there's a new salvation, and the only true happiness this way lies. And then there is one more, and I see a haiku there, and I'm going to say that for the end. This one is called Violations Tested. When driving to meet someone who had so little time off for lunch, was running late, still a few miles on a stretch of I-20 to their office. So, although the sign said 30, I went 55, following a cop speeding down the street. So after about a mile, that copper turned on his lights and signaled me over. And he walked over to my Saturn, asked me if I knew how fast I was going. And I replied, saying, I don't know. I was just following you, sir. And I waited. If he wrote me a ticket, he would be on record showing that he was speeding without being in pursuit. If he wrote a ticket, his faults would be on record, and cops want to think that they're just invincible. So the cop finally said to me, after looking at me for more than a moment, watch what you're doing, and watch your speed in the future. That's all he said. And I very subserviently said, yes, sir. And I, just a little bit slower, went on my way. One more before I call up our featured tiny, tiny little one here. It's called Poem About This. A poet walks into a coffee shop, sees a rabbi, a father, and an imam. And the poet thinks, I should write a poem about this.